there's this great story about NASA. So remember when we were talking about how Boeing's not been doing too well lately? The DOJ took them to court. There was the small matter of those two planes that crashed, killing everyone on board. They're still being held to account for that and pleading guilty to a few things, but got off lightly with a sweetheart deal. And we joked at the time, were the people who were flying into space on Boeing vehicles, were they worried that maybe they weren't going to make it home safely? Well, it turns out they are stuck up in space and wondering how to get home. And Elon Musk's SpaceX is going, maybe we better rescue these guys. Although, to their credit, they are keeping in very good spirits while they're stuck up there. Check out this of them having their own little Olympics since they're missing out on it while they're out in space. Hilariously, Steve Stitch, program manager for NASA's commercial crews, trying to find out what the best way forward is and what the heck happened on this Boeing machinery they've used to get up there. He says, I think the NASA community in general would like to understand a little bit more of the root cause and the physics. Yeah. I think especially the people who arrived on board that particularly Boeing vehicle and now are wondering how to get home. This was supposed to be an eight-week-long journey. A week-long journey.
Week. Yeah.
And now is blowing out to potentially 8 months long because they're just like, well, I guess we're in it for the long haul until somebody can get us home.
So this all goes back to when NASA decommissioned the space shuttles, and then to get into space, they either had to get a ride with the Russians or they had to get some private company to do it. So they gave multi-billion dollar contracts to Boeing and to SpaceX, owned by Elon Musk. And you'd expect Boeing to be all over this. But, of course, as you said, Liz, they've had so many problems with their aircraft. I mean, spacecraft are so much more complicated. Some of their initial efforts at this Starliner spacecraft, this is Boeing, software bugs meant some of the first rockets they shot went in the wrong direction. Then they had flammable tape inside the cabin of the space ship, which is probably not good. Two liftoffs were aborted. And finally, when they got a couple of astronauts on this spacecraft going to the International Space Station, it had thruster problems and gas leaks that they're still trying to work out what it is. And like you said, Liz, I don't blame the astronauts for saying, we'd like to understand a little bit more of the root cause before we get back in this thing and try and make it to Earth. So now Elon Musk, who's getting smashed by governments all around the world, but the American Biden administration can make a choice, can't they? Your astronauts can come back with Musk. Or there's a Russian rocket that they could hitch a ride with.
Which one would you trust more? The Russians, who've been trying to beat us in the space race since forever, you know, well, it might just magically combust on the way home. Or Boeing, which may well do exactly the same thing. And they're surmising that, oh, you know, maybe it was like some of the valves were too small. Like, OK. But before you got on a rocket ship to go up to the International Space Station, you'd like to think they'd done their due diligence to make sure that every little bit of that vessel was exactly as it should be. But no, it's Boeing. They have doors fly off mid-air. And what was the other story we talked about recently? They were using metal apparently that had been, you know, come out of China that hadn't been properly accredited.
And whistleblowers that keep showing up dead. And so weird.
And you're like, yeah, I'm going to go to space on a Boeing rocket. I would have gone in totally the other direction. Now, you know, the one silver lining could potentially be that if you got stuck on the International Space Station and you didn't particularly like your spouse, it may actually be a really nice holiday for a little while. They may well be saying, I don't want to go home. I'm I'm quite enjoying it up here on the International Space Station. And if they're getting up to that sort of fun, like the International Space Station Olympics, I mean, I want to know how they do the diving and all the stuff up there.
I found that clip offensive, to be honest, because I felt like they weren't appreciating the gravity of the situation.
No.
Oh, get out. I can't keep up with the dad jokes. I cannot keep
fantastic.
Up with the dad jokes.
I'll be here again next week.
But it's a brilliant opportunity for Elon to be the hero here.
Yeah,
so
totally.
He's now launching a rocket on the 24th of September, but it's only going to have two people on board instead of the usual four, so they can go up there, retrieve the two lost lambs that Boeing has left hanging, and return triumphant in February of next year. I love it. I absolutely love it. I'm like, ha-ha, what a middle finger to Boeing.
Exactly.
And Elon, who has been so demonized, gets to be like, you're welcome.